Welcome back, my viewers. You are tuned into Iceman Etika's channel, where you're watching the latest and greatest Pokemon battles. Literally, I'm uploading these videos like 2 days in a row, so I mean, yeah, you're pretty much getting the latest of the 5th gen. Basically, this is my second video, so I still feel the need to do an introduction, because there may be some people out there who don't exactly know what my basis is or where I come from. I'm going to be pretty forward with my information. I'm from Brooklyn, New York. I love Pokemon, and I love Sonic the Hedgehog as well. I'm not going to take too much time rambling on. Anyways, this match was against someone named Trevor, who was a really cool guy. He was really nice to fight against. I talked to him for a while. I met him in the Serebii chat room. We exchanged information and everything, so this should be a very good match. We had to retry the match 3 times because of bad internet connection, but you know what? It was still good. Anyways, Trevor's information will be found in a link below in the description, so please check that out. Subscribe to him, and let's get this match going. So, Trevor, he was definitely a little bit more original than some other people. I mean, he leads with the Bisharp. I don't see too many of those. Or maybe I'm just missing the right people. But anyways, I lead with Bistro. Now, you all know Bistro is the beast. So anyways, I lead out with the Earthquake. Now, you know he steals, so that's going to do a lot. I was surprised it didn't kill him. However, I was thinking that he might be Focus Sash, and so now he comes with a Sword Dance. And so when I see that, I'm thinking, okay, he might have a Sucker Punch on him. So I go into my own last match MVP, Lucifer. Now Lucifer, I thought at least maybe I could hit him with a Heat Wave, but he switches out instead, and he goes to Ferrothorn, which is even better. Come on. Anyways, I go for a Heat Wave, of course, and I might as well. Oh, I actually do hit him. Yeah, I know Bisharp down to Bisharp. Anyway, so yeah, Bisharp is done. Then he sends in Swanna. Now, I know Swanna has bad defenses, but I still don't want to mess around and get Lucifer Sash ready, so I go into Windtuck. Extremely good special defense. I'll take this Hurricane like a pro. Look how much this does. I mean, it does a lot. I'm not saying it did, but I mean, come on. I mean, do you see that? Anyways, I set up the light screen so I can take another one of those and set up another screen alongside with it. So, pretty much it's turning into a good match. He plays really good. I was surprised how much attack that Swanna had. Anyways, so it doesn't kill me. I survive with 1 HP. Do you see that? And I go for the Ice Beam. Now, I know Swanna has bad defenses, so this does do a little bit more than I thought. And he gets the freeze, but he just thaws out again. So, I mean, it's real funny when that happens. Now, he goes for the Roost. Very smart on his part, because that Ice Beam did a lot of damage. So, I figure I can take him out with another one. I thought he would have switched, but I just was like, whatever. So, I hit him with another one, and I'm faster, of course. So, that's the end of Swanna. Take care. It's a beautiful Pokemon, though. Very original. I haven't seen many people use it. And now, Lapras. Now, this was a very original Pokemon. Now, I really like Lapras a lot. I actually used one back in the old days. I kicked Herschel's ass with it. Anyways, so Windtuck dies. I had to make that sacrifice. I didn't want anything else taking the Ice Shard, so I send in Madre. And, of course, you know what comes up next. The Retaliation in the face, of course. And let's see what the damage is like. Oh, that's quite a lot. I mean, really. Anyways, he goes for the Hydro Pump. It misses, but I still have the light screen up, so it wouldn't have killed me. And he sends in Ferrothorn. Now, I knew he would switch, so I do the Workup. Workup is Kangaskhan's biggest gift in this generation. I mean, it makes him so much more of a threat. Now for the Drain Punch, take the health back, and plus he has Scrappy too, so he'll be able to hit Ghost along with that Workup too. One hit KO, I mean, sure it was a critical, but I mean, it did a whole lot of damage for so much defense that Ferrothorn has. I get hit by the Iron Barb, doesn't really matter though. I get the Life Orb damage, but I get healed by the Drain Punch. So, I mean, this is starting off pretty well so far. So he goes to the Ampharos. Now I go into another Retaliate. Even at 70 base, still stab, still with a Workup. I mean, it does a lot. Now he goes to the Focus Blast. I'm thinking, will this kill me? So I'm looking like, okay, I hope it doesn't. Oh wait, it doesn't, because I have a light screen up. And besides, it's non-stab. I mean, it's an Ampharos. I mean, I'm not saying Ampharos is a bad Pokemon, but I don't see the... Anyways, but you know what? It's all good. I mean, this guy, he used it pretty well. I mean, anyways, Ampharos goes down. I take the health straight from him. So right now, you know, Madre is ready to roll. You know, I'm rearing to go. So he goes into the Sudowoodo. I'm thinking he has the Sucker Punch, so I go for the Drain Punch instead. However, he doesn't, so that was pretty good on my part. I take almost all his health away. And just one thing, Madre is ready to fight. You know, she's ready. And then the Hammer Arm. So now I'm like, okay, that's pretty much it. I mean, I don't even have a Reflect Up. So Madre, yeah, your streak is done. So I withdrew her. And then, who do I go into next? Bistro. Of course, Bistro. Now, you know what's coming up. Earthquakes. I mean, come on. This is one of the most commonly used moves in the game. I mean, of course that's coming. Anyway, so Sudowoodo's down. Then finally, he goes back into his Lapras. And I say, a quick finish to this. I hit him with the Rock Slide. And with the sheer force boost and everything else, it's pretty much a KO from there. So that was an excellent match, Trevor. He's a really good guy, everybody. I mean, don't think anything of the battle. I mean, it was a good match. We had to restart the match 3 times because of bad internet. And we had a very, very even showing at a match before this. But this is the only one that got recorded. But still, please subscribe to him. Give him a visit, friend him, do whatever, but this guy is really cool, you know what I mean? And I don't really say that about too many people. You know what kind of person I am. So he's a really cool guy. Like, make sure you treat his channel with some love or something like that, right? Anyways, that's pretty much it for this battle. Please stay tuned for the next one. I'm probably going to upload it sometime later today or tomorrow or something like that. Regardless, these battles are coming now, and remember, this is Etika's channel, originality at its finest. Take care, have a good one, and peace. Oh, and speaking of which, shout outs to the SSMB, shout outs to Kingsborough Community College, all the people in the clusters, shout outs to all the people in the Men's Resource Center, shout outs to Rashad, shout outs to a whole bunch of people, you know, I'm black, this is what we do, we shout out people. Anyways, take care, and I'll see you all later. Have a good one.